Welcome to 4DDIG. When you're trying to reinstall or upgrade your Windows operating system, you may get this error: we couldn't create a new partition or locate an existing one. Don't worry, you're not alone. In this video, we'll show you 5 best methods to fix this installation issue. But before we get started, subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any future videos. Before diving into the methods, it's crucial to back up your hard drive first to prevent any data loss during the troubleshooting process. 4DDIG Partition Manager is a safe and easy disk cloning tool that allows you to clone partitions or create complete disk backups. Through cloning, you copy and transfer all your hard drive data to an SSD or HDD, which can be extremely helpful for tasks like data recovery, system migration, or storage drive upgrades. To get started, download 4DDIG Partition Manager from the official website or find direct download link in the video description. Launch the tool and connect a new SSD. On the main screen, select Clone Disk. The source disk will be pre-selected by default, so manually select the connected SSD as the target disk and click Continue. Confirm your selection by clicking Sure and hit Start. The disk cloning will start and take some time to complete, depending on the data size of the hard drive. After your hard drive data is successfully backed up, let's move to the solutions for fixing we couldn't create a new partition. Sometimes, external devices can interfere with the installation process. So make sure you disconnect any external hard drives, USB devices, or SD cards from your computer. After that, restart your PC and insert your Windows installation media, USB or DVD, or boot from the source you're using for installation, then start again. DiskPart is a command line utility that allows you to manage disk partitions. You can use it to resolve issues related to partitioning during Windows installation. First, insert the installation USB or DVD to your computer and start the Windows installation. Once you get the "We couldn't create a new partition" error message, press Shift plus F10 to open the command prompt. Type diskpart and press Enter. Then type list disk and hit Enter to view all the available disks. Now, type select disk 0, replace 0 with the number that represents your hard drive, and hit Enter. Type clean and hit Enter to delete all information on that drive. Afterwards, type create partition primary size 120,000. Here enter the partition size accordingly. Now you should type format FS equals NTFS quick and press enter for a quick format. Once done, type assign letter J, hit enter, and then type active to make that partition usable. Now type list volume. This will list all the partitions and drives, including the newly created partition. Go ahead by typing exit twice to exit from diskpart. Return to the Windows installation process, and now you should be able to select the formatted partition as the installation destination without encountering the previous error. If your hard drive or system partition has been inactivated by mistake, then this type of error will appear. Follow these steps to make the hard drive to mark partition as active partition. Step 1, insert the bootable Windows USB drive into your PC. Launch the installation and click on Setup Date, Time, and Keyboard Input Method. Step 2, on the next screen, click on Repair Your Computer. Now select the Troubleshoot option and then click on Command Prompt. Step 3, now it's time to write the following commands one by one and press Enter afterward. Type diskpart and hit Enter. Now type list disk and hit Enter. All available disk will be displayed. Select your desired boot-up disk using Select Disk 1 command and press Enter. Now, type list partition and it will display all the partition available in your system. Select desired partition using Select Partition 1 and hit Enter. Now your partition is selected, and finally type active and press Enter. That's it. An incorrect boot order could also mislead your computer to boot from a hard drive, then it will display such types of error. So make sure your system hard drive is in the first place of the boot order. You can change boot order using BIOS menu. Step 1. Restart your computer and press a specific key such as Delete, F2, F10 to enter BIOS setup. Step 2. Access the boot tab using the right arrow keys on your keyboard. And move your system hard drive to the top of the boot order list. Step 3. Make sure to save that updated BIOS setting using F10 key and simply restart your system. That's it. Hopefully, you were able to solve the error message "we couldn't create a new partition or locate an existing one using above methods." For migration, optimization, and managed disk partitions, we strongly recommend using 4DDIG Partition Manager. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you want more useful tips. See you next time.